A 26-year-old pregnant woman delivered a boy an hour ago. She has a history of gestational diabetes. She was prescribed insulin for that, but she hasn't taken it routinely because she believes that insulin may harm her baby. She has a history of alcohol consumption on weekend before the pregnancy. She doesn't have any other medical history. On examination, the newly delivered boy looks irritable. His blood glucose level is 30 milligram per deciliter. She didn't breastfeed him yet. Which of the following additional finding would most likely see in this baby? The options are decreased C-peptide level, increased insulin-like growth factor, macrosomia, retinopathy, and decreased thyroid-stimulating hormone. Now you can pause the video and answer the question. If you already have answered the question, now let's discuss the case. Here we can see that the pregnant woman has a history of diabetes, but she does not take the insulin for that. So lady has uncontrollable diabetes, and she also takes the alcohol, but that is not that much significant for the fetus because it has a conception before the pregnancy and it was in the low quantity, so that is not going to affect his baby. And the baby looks irritable and he has a blood glucose level is 30. Here we can see that uncontrollable diabetic mother and hypoglycemic fetus. So they are asking the uncontrollable diabetic mother's effect on his fetus. So we need to understand the effect of diabetic mother on his baby. So here we can see that mother is diabetic, so she has a high blood glucose level. High blood glucose will further crosses the placenta, which will increase the blood glucose level in the fetus. When blood glucose level of the fetus increase, the fetus pancreas try to control the blood glucose level via increase the production of the insulin. So this lead to increase insulin production in the fetus via beta cell hyperplasia. But here one thing we need to note, that as blood comes in the fetus from the mother, that continuously comes hyperglycemic blood. So the fetus need to control it via again and again increase the production of the insulin. So that will lead to beta cell hyperplasia in the fetus pancreas. And as we already know, when the insulin release from the pancreas, it also release the C-peptide along with the insulin. So when the insulin level increase, the lab will find increased C-peptide level, and we need to understand the effect of the insulin on the body. The insulin works on the adipose tissue and any other cell via increase the uptake of the glucose inside the cell. So whenever glucose level increase, the insulin try to decrease blood glucose level via uptake of the glucose from the blood. So glucose will transfer into the cell and cell will enlarge. That will lead to fat deposition in the body, and this will further leads to macrosomia of the fetus. Any other finding would lead to organomegaly also seen, but mainly this is the fetus will find macrosomia, and the body weight of the fetus would be higher than the normal in the uncontrollable diabetic mother. So our right answer would be macrosomia. Why not the other answer? Let's see about it. Decreased C-peptide level is not the case. It will increase the C-peptide level. Increase insulin growth like growth factor will not the answer. Retinopathy will seen in the chronic condition that will affect the retina. But here is the newborn baby, which is around newly delivered now. That will not also the case. And the decreased thyroid, that will also not the case. So our right answer would be macrosomia. I hope you understand this case and its concept. Thank you.